Hello there, my name is Iain Toombs from gofishing.co.uk. Welcome to part 5 of our video, Saturday evening. And instead of being in the pub, I got my spear and Jackson's out and I'm stood in the River Welland and I'm just tidying up our swims. That was probably the last job really we need to do, because the baiting, we've got that nailed. We keep putting the bait in every single night. And all that's left for us to do create fishable spots really, because obviously this is a wild river, it's not heavily fished and it's the first day of the season, and somebody has to clear an area. Now the main thing is we've got permission to do this. We contacted Deep and St James Angling Club, the controlling club for the whole of this stretch, and they've given us permission to get in here, pre-bait, fish the swim, cut down whatever we need to cut down, and as long as we don't leave a mess, which we won't do, everything's going to be a-okay. All this stuff's going to rot in time and it'll all be pushed out the way. So, oh, and also we've checked the reeds as well, because obviously it's nesting time. So, you know, we've double checked that. We actually checked that well before we even started picking the swim. So we're safe on that ground as well. Now, although I've been cutting down with the shears, I don't need those anymore because this is now cleared. This is what I'm going to need. Get the weed rake out again, because behind me there's a lot of weed just down the edge, up to about 3 rod lengths out. Now if we catch a fish, or if we don't catch a fish, our rigs are going to be pulled through it anyway. So all that needs to come out as well. Actually, I think that'll probably take 20 minutes, something like that. Just drag, I don't know, 20 sweeps with the rake, throw it in nice and close, sweep it, pull it really gently along the bottom. That'll clear all that out. There are a few stick-ups as well out in the middle of the river with a good chuck with a weed rake, and quickly yank it back. They'll pull them stalks out as well. And then, I think we're just about ready. Bloody heart's beating a bit, I'll tell you. So, I'll carry on clearing this swim, move on to the next swim, clear that, and then we've got one final job to do, and that's to let everybody else know that we're going to be here. And the only way we're going to do that is, well, if you haven't seen it on the internet anyway, we're going to put a little notice out, hammer that into the ground, let everybody know that we're here by permission, it's pre-baited, and fingers crossed, that'll reserve the swim for us. Okay, so that's tonight. Tomorrow is the final day before the open season. Now, we've put in that much bait already. There's no point really in piling a load more bait out on the Sunday evening, because that's going to fill up all the fish anyway. So we're going to revisit the swim, but this time, instead of putting out brown crumb, flake maize, boilies, pellets, sweet corn, all that sort of thing, we're just going to put out just a few balls of brown crumb and a few grains of sweet corn, just to keep the fish interested and in the swim. So we'll do that tomorrow. There'll be not a lot else to say, so there'll be no video on Sunday. The next video you're going to see is live on the bank on June the 16th, opening day. And hopefully on this area here, you're going to see quite a few unhooking mats with quite a few bream, tench, and possibly the odd carp in there as well. Because yesterday we saw that big ghost carp. We haven't seen it again this evening, but I'm not surprised at all the commotion that's been here. But okay, so fingers crossed, we'll see you on next film with a decent bag of bream and some action to show you as well. Thanks very much.